Hi, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to be discussing how to reprogram your mind for success and for more impact. So why do we need to reprogram the mind? There's an underlying assumption there that the mind is already programmed in a way, which is true. We have lived our lives for a very long time and it has fossilized in a way. It knows our patterns, it knows what we do every day. And the brain already, once you wake up in the morning, it knows what you need, it gives it to you, and it doesn't expect anything different from what you have been doing. And that's how it is. That's how our life, you know, has been programmed to work, and our thoughts have been programmed, you know, to be effective in that way. So if you feel you're not doing enough, if you feel you're not making enough progress or achieving enough of the things that you want to achieve, then you might want to consider reprogramming your mind. For me, it's something you just have to do every day. I don't think there's any pill that has been invented that you can take to reprogram the mind. I know that there are various practices that people use to do it, but still, I don't know if anything is permanent. So most of them to me are just intellectual exercises, you know. The real practical thing to me is that you have to do it every day. Basically, you have to keep at it every day, because the mind is negative by nature. So you have to build in habits that will help you stay positive, and it has to start from the inside. The first thing, of course, is awareness that there is a problem. If you're still on the video now, that means you're aware that you may need to reprogram your mind. I am also aware. I'm doing it. I do it every day. I woke up today feeling down. I think I wake up every day feeling down, you know. And I have to pull myself up every day. I need to inject myself with motivation from inside every day. I have to do it every day, because once I go to sleep, my whole body and everything goes back, resets itself, you know, to the default setting that I am. And that's how I woke up this morning. But I said, no, I'm going to do this video. So yeah, awareness, number one. You need to see it. You need to see the pattern. You need to know that you need to change it. You need to be fully conscious, you know, that, yeah, this thing is needed. I need to change this in my life. And the second thing, of course, once you're aware, that means you can notice when those thoughts come in. You can feel your emotions. You can feel it in your body, because it's embodied. The mind is embodied. The body is the subconscious mind. So you feel it already. Like, you already know all your cells. When they wake up in the morning, they already know what to do. Your DNA, you know, everything. Your body already knows what to do. So that's the first one, awareness. Secondly, you have to change your story. This is another internally focused aspect, you know, of reprogramming your mind. You have to change your story. You need to understand that you are not your thoughts, first of all, and those thoughts they really don't belong to you. So you have the ability to choose. You have the freedom, you have the free will, let me use that word, you know, to choose which line of action you're going to follow, which train of thought you're going to jump on for the day. And by doing that, you're changing your story. You need to change the story you tell yourself about yourself. By changing that story, you're convincing yourself, because, you know, there's a dialogue in our mind all the time. And this dialogue is always between self-doubt and self-belief. Now, but for me, most times, self-doubt was winning before. But these days, I've empowered self-belief to take the wheel, you know, of my life. So, but self-doubt always comes in the morning, because I don't know where, it still has the key. Maybe it has a duplicate key. So it comes and starts my engine for me. It starts with self-doubt. And when I've moved for, like, I don't know, 10 minutes or something, you know, I asked self doubt to come out and let self belief take over the driver's seat. And that's why I'm here making this video. I was doubting so much whether I was going to do it. I didn't know what topic to talk about, but I just remembered this and said, okay, yeah, this is what I'm doing now. I'm trying to reprogram my mind, so why not just talk about it? So yeah, that story needs to change. You know, you need to believe in yourself. You know, you need to think that you can achieve whatever you want to achieve in a day. It's not everything that you can achieve, but at least you make the effort. Then another aspect of reprogramming our mind is by taking inspired action. I told myself I'll be doing exercise every morning, and that's the most difficult thing for me to do. It has always been the most difficult thing for me to do, right from when I was young, right from my university days. I just feel that it's so painful and everything. But I had to do it this morning. I haven't done all. I did part of it. I will go back to do the other part of it. But it reinforces that change that you're trying to make. Taking that inspired action, despite how difficult it is, this is not something that can be taught to you. You just have to do it. You have to take the action. Depending on what you want to do, you know, you just have to take that action and do it. Like for me to do this video, I just had to put the phone on the tripod, you know, and just push and just do it, you know. And yeah, that's how I was able to get here. There's no other way. You must have that internal desire for change. Nobody can teach anybody how to change. You know, there just has to be that internal desire to change, which is normally triggered that would be another discussion for another day, you know, because you need to have suffered enough before you would even want to consider changing. Because why would anybody change something that's working for them already? There's just no need trying to change anything trying to change what is already working for you. So the fourth thing I want to talk about here is gratitude. Just by being grateful, you know, every day, every morning, I talked about journaling some time ago, but it's not easy. I've not been able to be consistent enough in the journaling. I don't know why. I just feel it's a lot of work. But yeah, I try to do my gratitude, you know, in my mind every morning. That's the first method or means I use to combat the negative committee that sits in my head. I'm just grateful for the day, grateful for waking up, and grateful for another opportunity to try. You know, that's what we do. We're just trying every day, and I'm just grateful for the opportunity to try once more, to try to make one more video, to try to do exercise, to try to play with my toddler, to try to love my wife and my family. It's just an extra day to do that in this world, and it's beautiful. Then the last one is affirmations, visualization. You always need to, I won't say think big, yeah, but thinking big is part of it. You always need to be able to visualize where you're going, you know, where you see yourself in the future, and let that vision guide you into the actions that you need to take today to get there. So I use that visualization because I remember my why I'm still here, why I haven't just committed suicide and gone. There's a reason why I'm alive, my purpose, my passion, my mission. So I keep that mental picture in my head, and I also have somewhere, you know, that I keep a reminder of myself, to tell myself, you know, that this is where I'm going to, this is where I've been, this is where I'm coming from, these are all the failures, you know, that have constituted my suffering and my problems, and this is what I've learned from them, and this is where I'm going to. So I have this visual image on my computer that if I just pull it up and I just look at it and I say, and I remind myself, wow, okay, this is where I'm going to. Then the affirmation part of it is just to speak kindly to yourself, speak your destiny, you know, into existence, speak your abundance into existence, believe that it's going to happen, believe that it's possible, and it will come to pass. You have to believe and then act, because faith without works, like I said, is dead. So yeah, those are my points for today, and thanks for listening to me, and subscribe if you haven't subscribed to my channel. Have a nice day. Bye.